The latest Minecraft 1.21 beta adds an abundance of new blocks to the game from the tuff and copper block set, which suspiciously matches the two golems that Mojang tried to add to the game, most recently via failed mob vote. Is this them telling us something about the update? Also, when it comes to the breeze, which is clearly the air elemental version of the blaze, will it have its own version of the blaze rod, or a breeze rod if you will? And finally, given that they updated the bat in this most recent beta too, is that a sign they're going to be redesigning other mobs as well? Well, actually, these aren't hypothetical questions. We actually have the answers from Mojang for all three of them, and today in Q&A Saturday, we'll be going through each and every one of those, so please do subscribe to the channel if you like this weekly update into what's going on in the Minecraft world, and we'll start with the most important of the three, which by the way comes in from J4Cult02, because maybe they're adding the golems to the trial chambers in a later snapshot, and this would make perfect sense given that the trial chambers are made up of copper and tough blocks, and given that the copper and tough golems are losers of the mob vote, but Mojang specifically says they go back to the idea library. If there ever was a time to go into the idea library and take something out of it, this update would make perfect sense, and that is why this is a slam dunk of a feature to be included, except funnily enough, we have direct confirmation from Mojang about the opposite, because this is the only public source. This is Silent Whisperer, another YouTuber, and he says that Mojang has confirmed that copper slash tough golems won't be in this update, and although I wouldn't usually take that as a source, it is worth mentioning there is another one, which is Mojang did a creator Q&A, where they confirmed when asked about the trial chambers being the opportunity for copper and tough golems, that we really love those little buddies, but not for this update. That is right, we are not going to be seeing any new golems of tough and copper variety in Minecraft 1.21. I think this is Minecraft trying to get past their golem problem by going cold turkey, and if you think about it, when you see the number of comments like people like this saying, the old mobs being in the game is nice, but the copper golem needs more of a use than the tough golem was just a glorified item display, you realize why it is that adding the failed mobs to the game is a bad idea. If the majority of the community looked at a mob and said, yeah, I don't really like that, or I massively prefer another mob, maybe those old ideas are bad concepts, and that's why I think there's some controversy in the mob vote. Whenever the three options are really, really close together, they all feel like good options. There are some really bad mob vote mobs that you should be glad they didn't add to the game. Going back to some of the earliest votes even, if you think about, there was this monster called the Monster of the Night Sky. It was just going to punish you for not sleeping. It had no additional value being added, and that was going to be a real thing they were going to add, and I'm just so glad we didn't vote for it personally. Anyway, speaking of things I'm glad about, the next question here is from RyanTastic01. Will the breeze drop a breeze rod similar to the blaze rod? Well, funnily enough, the exact same creator Q&A, which by the way I wasn't a part of, but I've obtained a copy of the answers, and Mojang is happy for you to share the content of the answers, but not the document it's about. It's very weird stuff. But anyway, they actually do directly confirm that the new hostile mob doesn't currently have a new drop, but they are looking into it, and they'll get back to us later. In other words, I think that means the breeze is going to have a drop, but it's going to need to have a function. And if you think about what they've added in this update, especially when it comes to the copper bulb with this recipe, they've added a new blaze rod recipe for the first time in quite some time, honestly, and it makes sense that this is a bulb that needs to be charged somehow. What if they had some new recipe or equivalent recipe that could use a breeze rod instead? This could either work as a variant of the blaze rod and allow you to craft things like a potion table that makes different potions. That's a fun idea to me. Or it could be used as an exact replica of the blaze rod, and this would allow for so much easier crafting for various items, but specifically, in my opinion, it would be the first time that Mojang would allow us to make IFenders without having to go to the Nether. That would be massive and game-changing, and honestly would make a new fun path to beat Minecraft. Go to the trial chambers, do some trading, and then you can go to the end without having gone to the Nether. Obviously, I like to clarify when I say something like that, unlike a lot of YouTubers, I would like to be honest with you and say, yeah, all of those things are reaches. Right now, we know there is a breeze. We know that almost every other hostile mob in the game has some unique drop. However, it doesn't have to be true for the breeze, and the breeze doesn't have to be related to the blaze, even though they have suspiciously similar names just from different elements, and so we'll have to wait and see for the next snapshots. I am excited for the next one, honestly. It seems as though we've had a couple of banger ones in a row, so the next weeks will be exciting. But while we wait for that snapshot, and indeed Bedrock Beta, I think it's worth addressing some of the things from last week's, such as the bat, which was updated, and what that means for the future, but also the 53 brand new blocks, which I called useless in my original YouTube video, and which I got a lot of pushback from. I got lots of comments saying stuff like, useless, it's a creative building game. They added new blocks to build with, WTF, man. You know, like people saying, like, it's kind of ridiculous to say that a block is useless when it's in a block building game, but actually, the reason I take the stance I do is because Mojang is usually very cautious about adding new blocks to the game, specifically because they want them all to have a use and fit in together. This is something they have said many times. That's why we don't have hundreds of new blocks in every update. And so if they're going to go ahead and break that, either break that by a lot and give us 100 blocks if you really are going to give us a building update, or make sure that the blocks you do add are very good. If you're going to go for the middle ground solution of adding a few blocks but they're not very useful, then it feels like a worst of both worlds situation. However, I'm actually really happy that I got so many comments saying, no, we love these blocks. No, what do you mean they're useless? We love this. I think that is a good sign for 1.21, because although, you know, this is probably the worst thing I've seen so far about the update, is there's a bunch of blocks that haven't done anything yet. In my opinion, this is an exciting update, and if the one criticism I have that I think is super valid, people hate and push back events, that is a sign that we're not gonna have a year of people being super mad about stuff. There won't be more things like the mob vote pushback, but every single week to Mojang, and instead we're on a big positive Mojang trend this year, which is great news in my opinion, because usually I'm excited by updates, and for the last couple ones, people have been pushing back saying, oh no, this is terrible, you don't understand, it's the worst update ever, and I'm glad that we're finally getting out of that, even if it means that when I say out loud that if you're only gonna add 12 variants of the new block that people were asking for ever since it was added just 3 updates ago, maybe you should have added it back then, but that's entirely fine in my opinion. Also, by the way, just to kind of finalize on that, I think something kind of fun is that Mojang probably actually did intend to release a new set of tough blocks when the tough golem was being voted on, and probably intended to release the new set of copper blocks when the copper golem was being voted on, and that now this is just a good opportunity to put them in there by combining these things together into the trial chambers. I agree with this theory a lot, and it actually makes me realize that, yeah, in the last couple of years, we had the alley and we had the sniffer. We could have got a whole new set of tough blocks if they were updating tough anyway. We could have had a whole new set of copper blocks, and I think it's crazy that we have no idea what we're voting for, because I really do believe that we would have gotten those things if we voted. But anyway, back to the bat, because is he getting an appearance change, or is he actually going to get a use? And sadly, if you want a mob that is useful, then no, the bat is not going to have a use besides, I guess, adding ambience to caves. It is going to remain unchanged on a gameplay level. It is just the appearance which has changed in a way that seems to divide people. And yeah, interestingly enough, I like this comment here saying that actually, if they redesigned the Vex last year, will they be redesigning other mobs? And 519 people agree with me. And it's fortunate because we have an answer from Mojang's behavior. And although many people would look at certain mobs, like the rabbit is the classic example of a mob that just kind of looks wrong in Minecraft. I've seen so many rabbit redesigns that just make the mob look more realistic, more like an actual rabbit in the real world does. But ultimately, the reason they won't be redesigning these mobs is because they're trying to make Minecraft more consistent, not in terms of tone and shading. So I've said many times before, the turtle looks ridiculous because it has a way higher pixel density than the cow. But the problem that Mojang is trying to adjust is having more pixels on the texture than the mob itself. And so if you look at the bat and you see how many pixels this mob has, and then you compare that to the pixels on the old texture, it looks kind of silly. The same is true for the Vex, and there seems to be only one other big example of where you can find this is... Wait, what is that? How did you get in here? There's this cat that just always wanders into my house, and he's just appeared in my office, so... Welcome everyone to Bingo Bongo. This is a slightly unwilling participant in the video today. I'll put him on the desk, actually. Oh no, it's going away. I now have to lure him back. I don't think he appreciates this. Sorry about that, but I think I own a cat now. He's chilling in the back of my office, which is important because I can go back into the important question of which mob also needs to be retextured. And the biggest example that comes to mind is the reverse situation of the Ghast, which is huge in terms of the actual size of it, although it's really just a big cube, so arguably one big pixel. But if you look at the texture, it is very blocky, and so this is the most logical contender. However, unlike the Bat and the Vex, which were added kind of recently in Minecraft's history, this is a much less recent mob, and and so that's something Mojang clearly needs to work on. Speaking of things they need to work on, I think something interesting from Kevin right here, which has 271 upvotes, is that the copper door would be so much better if they were the first Minecraft doors that required actual keys to unlock. Hear me out, the copper doors naturally spawn in the trial chambers. The trial chambers are supposed to be challenges. What if the only way to progress in the trial chamber is to receive a key from defeating the spawners or from finding the keys in new pots? I think this is such a good idea, by the way. I think the point of the trial chambers is to kind of emulate some of that Legend of Zelda style gameplay. It kind of emanates out from when you look at this structure, and so logically, if you're going for Legend of Zelda style gameplay, one of the big things they had in that game were small keys and big keys that you unlocked throughout the thing, which allowed you to unlock new doors. The only reason that I think this isn't a slam dunk of an idea that you can guarantee will be in there is solely because how are you going to guarantee, you know, like for example, that the mechanic will work outside of the trial chambers in an interesting way? How would you lock the door with a key and then try and find it? It would be a really messy Minecraft mechanic, and so I think the way they'd have to do it is clearly make it that once the door is unlocked the first time, it just becomes something that is open normally, and so wow, if we were to see copper doors that were unlockable, we would probably see them spawn in a way like Suspicious Sand and Gravel does, where if you try to place them anyway but naturally, they don't really work in the intended way, and so maybe that's what we'll be seeing in future betas and snapshots. Only time will tell, but speaking of things that time will tell, CourtneyKing3699 says, "At IBX Toy Cat, I've been playing on your super flat world from the marketplace. Can we get the new woods and update it soon, please?" And you know what? This is a really valid question. Every single marketplace map has to be updated when there's a new Minecraft update, which is something we had to do anyway. And so when 1.20.40 came out, you can download a brand new update for Ultra Flat Survival for free if you already own it. And inside of that will be the new woods. Inside of that will be a new archaeology mechanic. That's right, adding archaeology to Ultra Flat actually worked out, in my opinion. And also, just to kind of future-proof it, just in case this comes up, we have it so now the Wandering Trader will be able to trade mending with you, so even if the villager trade changes come through, you'll still have a backup solution for getting mending, something I know is very important. All of the other features from 1.20.30 will also work in there now, and so I'll be starting a new Ultra Flat Survival, probably as soon as I'm back, because I've got a trip coming up, and so by the way, next week's snapshot video will be a little bit goofy, just a quick warning. But speaking of a quick warning, I want to make sure I give you a warning about this next comment, because it is referring, of course, to the Roger Badgerman situation. Why would they even take them down? They basically spew out hype in the community, which is a good result for Minecraft. And so it's funny, lots of people were sure, like 100% sure, that Roger Badgerman had to be a Mojang account, which was created to drive up hype for the game, because it totally did that. Every single leaking account for every major game, indeed, every single leaking account for tech products as well, does a really good job at getting people to talk about the product early, especially enthusiasts. You and I care a lot about what's inside 1.21, whereas the average person on the street, if you gave them an early copy of the update, they genuinely might not be able to spot what's new in the update versus what's not, because maybe they haven't played Minecraft, or they haven't played it in a very long time. And so, yeah, it's important to get new information to people who care about it the most, and it seems as though leaker accounts like, you know, the Dangionis and the Roger Badgemans of the world are designed to do that. However, the reason that it's not is because Mojang spends a lot of money on PR and these big campaigns on making things look perfect and pretty, and yeah, obviously they don't like when people undercut that and make it so fewer people care about their big announcements because they've already heard about them elsewhere. Speaking of things that people don't care about elsewhere, Fekita, I want to appreciate your comment here because they say, "How you doing, Toy Cat? You didn't really take too much time off yourself. Love your positivity, mate. I hope you're doing good." And yeah, this is obviously, you know, a lot of people, something I learned about. I'm learning so much about the world of death, and I'm trying to share it frankly with the internet. It's in line with the openness and the honesty that I try to add to as many elements of my life as possible. Everyone is probably aware that I am sad because my mother died. You know, it's a very easy thing to work out, but there are a few things that you're probably not aware of, and one of those that I've learned about from this whole weird experience since is that most jobs actually have some form of support for you, and so if someone in your life dies, if it's a spouse or it's a sibling or something like that, you usually get a lot of time off work, paid time off work that doesn't count towards your holiday. And I don't know, like I obviously do a big self-employed thing, so the world of work is a little bit foreign to me, but that is something that also is foreign to me. The idea that, like, oh yeah, so like someone died, so you just kind of like get to take time off, it sounds very nice for those people, but obviously it is something that I do not benefit from. Being on YouTube, I am running my own business here, and you know, ignoring even the financial aspect of, like, I literally cannot just decide to not upload for 30 days, you know, and take some time to do whatever. I am trying to make sure that I do take some time for myself by, you know, making videos and then having days off using some of the time from those videos. Hopefully you've been, you know, enjoying the content regardless. But the other thing that I think is important is my mother was a very, very hard worker. It was like one of the big things that she like drove into me. It's like, it's important to work real hard. And I also think that even ignoring like the whole like who it is that is dead, it's really important to realize that you... you don't do your job solely for money usually. At least maybe I'm fortunate this way, but I really value what it is that I do here. I like that I am helping people, and I like the connections that people are making. And I even just like the basic element of like, yeah, a lot of people saw this thing, so clearly that means that it's been helpful. I love that element of what I do here on the internet, and it's not something that I want to give up. I think it's something that's healthy for my recovery to help as many people as possible. And sometimes that's in telling you about your copper golems and tough golems and how they're not actually coming to the game, even though they'd make sense. And sometimes that's in ways by being like, death is a thing that happens at some point and we don't like to talk about, but there's a crazy whole other side of the world that's going on there. I learned, for example, that like, you can't, so it varies a lot by how it works, but like funerals are like a big part of the business of like, like policing, like I mentioned, but also hospitals, but also there's this whole like industry around like, oh, someone dies, we're gonna cash that. It costs a lot to have a funeral, for example. There's all these things that we don't talk about that if we knew about and if we were willing to confront, I think we'd be more informed. Here's a dumb one, for example. Did you know in the UK you don't actually buy your grave slot, you rent it for some number of years. And so one of like the hard decisions about that came from this is like, I think it's rented for my parent for like 30 years, something like that, 35. And so it means like in my lifetime, they're gonna dig it up, they're gonna put it somewhere, and then someone else gets to rent that land. I think it's 75 years by default in the UK, but still, it's like a lot of people assume like, yeah, you get buried, then your tombstone lasts forever, but someone has to replace that thing regularly. Someone has to keep paying rent on your land regularly, or indeed you have to like buy a permanent plot, which is a lot more expensive. There's a lot of things you don't think about, is what I'm saying, and maybe you should think about them. Or maybe you shouldn't. It's up to you. Anyway, for now, all I want to say is thank you for the support. I'm about to go on a trip to the United States, then to Canada, then back to the United States. It's going to be a fun trip. Going to give me an opportunity to kind of clear my head. And yeah, in the meantime, I hope you enjoy the stuff that's on the channel. Just in case you don't, did you know you can get Ultra Flat Survival for the low, low price of 660 mine coins? It is the best super flat experience that you can have. It's split up into biomes. There's so many fun changes we've made. I'm excited to play it when I get back. And if you want to have the ultimate experience yourself, so you can maybe kind of play along, you can start that in the mean coming week. But yeah, for now, I hope you'll enjoy this video. Check out Ultra Flat, and I feel obliged to plug my merch because, wow, look, today is a Monday. Isn't this the best shirt to wear on a Saturday? It's actually just turned Saturday as I record this. So anyway, I hope you've all enjoyed this video, and make sure that you have a good day, or don't. It's entirely your choice, huh? Okay, goodbye.